Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss on the basics of information technology. This is the last chapter of the course Business 106, Business Information Technology. We are going to discuss some of the important terminologies which are essential to be known to all the business students who are studying in Dhofar University to get an idea about what are the things that they should know about information technology in this particular one. I will explain one by one, just have a clear observation, and you can keep a piece of paper with you to make a note of the points, and if you have any questions, you can put it in the end. So now let's start with the first one. You have been studying about data. You know what is data? Data is a collection of raw facts, such as it can be a collection of numbers, names, places, etc. The only thing is that there is no specific meaning and it is not useful to the user in its original form. When you are going to have a data, like for example, I have a number like 20160123. What is this number? Somebody can think that is a telephone number. Somebody may imagine that it is like a bank account number. Somebody who is in the university may think that it is the university ID of the student. So there is no meaning that you can specifically attach to this. So this is actually called a raw fact. A fact which is not clear and understandable to the user is called a data. So I hope this is not a new concept. You have studied this one in the foundation program. Maybe even in your schools you have studied about these things. But just it's for you to know a bit again on this one. Now the next one that you are going to see is about information. What is information? A processed data is called information. A data which is processed is called an information. That means there is some manipulation done on the data. There is some changes done on the data that it becomes organized. A processed data, or also it is called an organized data, is called information. What is the difference between data and information? Data is not useful, whereas information is useful and help the users to understand the meaning of the facts given. For example, I give 20160123 Ahmad Musallam BA in MIS. If I give like this, then it becomes very clear. This is the ID of the student who is studying in BA in MIS in Dhofar University. So this is the second thing that you have to know. The third thing that you have to understand, this is just like a vocabulary or a glossary for you, IT glossary or the glossary for IT concepts for any business graduates. Information technology is the use of computers to store, retrieve, transmit and manipulate data or information. You see the word, it is used to store. We can store the data, retrieve, get back the data from the computer, transmit, you can send it to other person, share it with other person, manipulate, you can change, making calculation. For example, if I want to add the student's marks, add some changes to the marks, that's called manipulation. I can do these things with what? Either the data or information. It is typically used in the context of business operations. It is typically used in the context of business operations as opposed to personnel or entertainment technologies. Okay, IT is used in business operations, not for personal and entertainment technology. Entertainment technology is mostly used in business operations, like it can be used in a bank, it can be used in ROP, it may be used in university, it may be used in school. In any business operation, it will be used. It is considered, IT is considered as a subset. ICT, ICT means what? ICT is what? Information and communication technology, in which IT is a subset. It's a part of ICT. IT is a part of ICT. So I think this is clear up to this one. Let's go to the next stage, which is called information system. What is information system? An information system or IT system is generally an information system, a communication system, or more specifically speaking, a computer system. Any computer system, any system which uses computer as a tool is called an information system, where it includes hardware, It includes hardware, software, peripheral equipment, and operated by users. For example, if you want to operate a system, you know what is a system? System is a group of components. The components that we have here are what? Hardware, software, peripheral equipment, and their users. When all these things are linked together, and then it is called an information system. An information system processing cycle, any information system has these three basic steps. The user will give an input, the input will be processed, and then you will get an output, which is an information from the system. Let me explain with an example. Now let us take an example of your university ID. You enter your university ID, you click check, you all get all the process happens. Searching is the process, and after the process is over, you get, for example, transcript. If you press transcript, the output is you get the transcript, the Kutta Darasya. So this is an example of the processing cycle in any information system. You give an input, based on the input the process takes place, and based on the process is done, you will be able to produce the output. This is what is called information systems. Now when I talk about the information system, already I told you it is having many parts. What are they? Number one, hardware. Number two, software, people, process. Process means set of rules, business rules, set of operations that is going to happen in a organization, and the peripherals. So all this together are called as what? The components of the information system. So a system means what? A set of components. So the information system has these five components embedded into it. So this is what you have to keep in your mind. Now let us talk about each of these components in a short way to make it clear for you. What is the components? Physical components of the computer are called hardware. Like whichever you can touch physically, whichever you can feel physically is called a physical component. The physical parts of the computer is called as what? Hardware. Software is nothing but the programs which are needed to run the computer system are called as software. There are two types of software available. Number one is called system software. The other one is called application software. Okay, what is the difference between the two? Windows operating system is called an operating system software. Why? Without Windows, you cannot operate any computer normally. You can use Linux, it's another operating system. But generally speaking, you need an operating system. So a program which is essentially embedded as part of the computer system, without which the computer cannot operate, that's called a system software. MS Office is an example of an application software. What is application software? Any software which is used for any specific purpose is called an application software. MS Office has Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Access. Word for word processing, where you can type documents. Excel is a spreadsheet package where you can have calculations done. And PowerPoint is for making presentations. Access is a database package. So MS Office is an application software because each of the programs in MS Office has specific purposes. Okay, what is process? Process refers to the calculations and manipulations involved in converting the data into information. As I told you, the basic cycle of any information system starts with the input, which is data, and then it becomes information. So process refers to the calculations and manipulations, what is going to happen to the system. So that's what is actually called as process. What is meant by people? People are the users who are authorized to use the information system. That means if you are a university student, you are authorized to use the system, information system of Dhofar University. If you are not a student of the Dhofar University, you don't have any access to use the information system of Dhofar University. So these are the five components. As I explained in the previous slide, you can see it. I have explained them a little bit for you to understand more clearly. The next thing that you have to know is what? Now you know what is information system, you know what are the components of the information system, then you are going to talk about what are the types of information systems. You see, there are different hierarchy levels in the management of any organization. Depending upon the level of organization, there are different types of information systems used. There are four types of information systems used. Number one is called transaction processing system. Number two is called management information system. Number three is called decision support system. And number four is called executive information system. So these are the different types of information systems available based on the type of the management managerial level or the level in the organization where you are going to work. Not all the people will use TPS in the organization. Not everybody will, all the people will use EIS. It depends on the level of the organization of the job role that you have got. You will use a particular type of information system. The next concept that I want to discuss with you is about computer network. One of the backbone of the information system, because now you see, can you access DUSIS online? Yes. Can you access ROP website online? Yes, to check the Mulkia or fine. Can you check your bank account online? Yes. That means what? You have to connect your computer with the server of the bank. How you can do that? Only with the help of computer network. Once you have a computer network, you can connect your computer with the server. The connections can be of many types. The network can be of many types. One is called LAN. The other one is called WAN. Even MAN is there. I did not mention it because it's okay, medium, and this is small, and that's large. WAN is large. Now, LAN means what? It is covering a small geographical area. LAN covers a small geographical area. WAN covers a large geographical area. Okay. One of the backbone of the information system is what? Computer network. Okay. Now you can see that it spreads across different locations. Now you can see without the network, it is not possible for accessing the information system from any location. If you want to access your information system locally within your organization, you use local area network LAN. If you want to use your information system across geographically in from your home, for example, or from another country, then you may go for WAN, wide area network. Internet is an example of WAN, wide area network. Now when we talk about networking, the first thing that comes to your mind is called internet. Internet is one of the important network, computer network, and is the biggest computer network which connects all the computers across the world. Information systems are accessed online using the URL. You know what is URL? When you open Google Chrome, for example, you will type www.du.edu.om. That is called URL, Uniform Resource Locator. You will type the web address and your website will be located. That means you connect to the server of that website through the URL, and you use many web browsers to do this one, such as Google Chrome, Mozilla, and Internet Explorer. I think Google Chrome is most commonly and most famously used web browser nowadays. Now, I think with this, we will stop for a while. I will stop the video here and I will continue my next discussion in the next video as a second part, because I feel it's better to break here. Now I covered up to slide number 10. So the remaining 14 slides I will cover in the, there are 24 slides in total. So the other 14 slides will be covered as part 2. I hope this is clear until now. Please stay tuned for the next video. Until then, see you. Bye.